the Loring Park community is mourning the loss of a beloved community member. He was murdered last night by a customer while working the cash register. And we do want to warn you, the details of this case are disturbing.
Hey there. Over the past 24 hours, a vigil has grown outside of Oak Grove Grocery where that beloved cashier was murdered. The store now closed until further notice. We talked with community members who say the neighborhood won't be the same.
There's a dark cloud over the Loring Park neighborhood tonight.
Kumbaya, my Lord.
After a community elder was snatched away too soon.
I had to ask to make sure I was hearing correctly.
A normal day turned sinister. Minneapolis police say just before 1 Friday afternoon, a 44-year-old suspect brought items to the counter here at Oak Grove Grocery. But then the suspect went behind the counter and assaulted the cashier.
Officers encountered a 66-year-old male with what appeared to be a golf club impaled into his torso.
The cashier was taken to HCMC, where he later died. As for the suspect, he's behind bars tonight.
You're beautiful. Thank you for this.
Tonight, we're learning this community saw the beloved victim as much more than a cashier.
Here's my friend. What can I say?
Daniel here has lived in this community for 25 years.
He always knew when I was ready to come in to get my coffee in the morning.
Daniel and other neighbors say they knew the victim as Robert Scafty.
I don't know what to do now because my friend is gone.
Not only is a friend gone, but so is a devoted volunteer and a professional dancer. The Facebook page Citizens for a Loring Park Community says this is a terrible loss and trauma for the Loring Park and Stevens Square neighborhoods.
You can feel his presence isn't here anymore.
Even though Robert is gone now, the community is working to keep his loving spirit alive.
And I think that this is a really good opportunity to honor what he's done for our community. He really is like a glue around here. We're missing him already.
Investigators tell us they're still trying to figure out what happened leading up to this murder. Back to you.